do this, do this, do this, do this, you reach that. Right? So this is called path of action, which are steps. There's a path, there's an achievement, there's a goal to be reached, and that's called karma yoga. Karma yoga is not just for action. There are four aspects of karma. You have a head, you have a heart, you have a hands, and you have energy. You are a composition of four. You means the body. The head, the heart, the hands, energy. Hands, when they do service, that's called karma yoga, the action. So now all actions you are offering to the Lord. The head means knowledge, study scriptures. Study Upanishad, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, study many scriptures. Try to understand about God. It's called head. Dhyana yoga. Devotion to the Lord in terms of puja and prayers is called bhakti yoga. Kriya means various types of pranayama and breathing practices. This will take you from progressively from step one step to other. This is called progressive path or path of doing. There's another path called direct path or path of being. In the path of being, there's no steps, there's no milestone, there is no what you call as a goal to be reached, because you are the goal. You have to recognize yourself. And how does the recognition happen? Through self-inquiry or atma-vichara. This is what Sri Ramana Maharshi taught. So if you look at the progressive path, human being is considered as a work in progress by God. Okay? It's a defective product. I have this suffering, I have this pain, I have ignorance, I have this thing, God save me. This is called path of surrender, path of action. So you are considered as work in progress. So in the path of God, this path, you are trying to surrender to God, you are trying to offer yourself, your actions to the God. Whereas in the direct path, through the four confusions created by the mind, get a clarity in the mind, realize who you are directly. So there's no path. Why there's no path? The God or consciousness is all pervading reality, everywhere. Okay? For all pervading reality, what steps will you have? Right? For example, if I tell you, go from here to here, there, the 10 steps you have taken. You have to take 10 steps from here to there. So now I'll tell you, take a few steps and reach yourself. How can you do that? You cannot take any steps to reach yourself, because you are the goal and you are the seeking. The entire spiritual direct path teaching is how to recognize yourself. There is no steps involved in that. There is only enquiry involved in that. That's what Sri Ramana Maharshi taught as Atma Vichara, or who am I? Enquiry. So in the path of progressive path of doing, one example I'm seeing. I meditate. The God is infinite. God is all powerful. God is merciful. I am weak. I am ignorant. Oh Lord, save me. I am surrendering to you. All my actions, all my emotions, all my feelings. So you are surrender. It's called path of surrender. In the path, direct path, you inquire. If all pervading reality is God, why am I not seeing it? If everything is God, I should experience it. There is a correction required in understanding. And this correction can come only through enquiry, which is based on atma-vichara. So you understand the difference, right? If everything is all pervading reality, where am I missing it? And am I work in progress? Or can I reach myself directly through enquiry? This is the path which was taught by Sri Ramana Maharshi. Through my enquiry. Any questions? Now, This is not judging which path is good or which path is bad. It's just stating what is there. Right? So people choose based on their approach. So in this class, we are only speaking of direct path or path of self-inquiry. Are you okay?
The inquiry is not an intellectual inquiry.
No, I'll tell you what is inquiry. Right? It's not intellectual. The intellectual part will come into Jnana Yoga. There are four aspects of karma. Head, heart, hands and energy. Head part is called Jnana Yoga, knowledge. This is actually dropping the knowledge, ignorance. It's not adding. Vichara. So that's why the clock shown there has only one dial, no time there. Now, 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 now. If you have to find out who you are, now. And here, this word is a peculiar word. In English, again, I find a lot of nice words. Now and here, right? You add them, what will happen? It will happen?
Nowhere.
Now and here, nowhere. The self-realization can happen now and here, where? Nowhere. Because Atma or consciousness is nowhere. But you have to find it now and here. No, you say, no, I'll find myself tomorrow. How can you find yourself tomorrow? You are here. So where you are, you have to find the self. No, I'll find it after 10 years of sadhana, I'll find out. How can you find yourself after 10 years of sadhana? You tell me. Huh? After 10 years of sadhana, you may find a nice girl or a boy to get married. That also I'm not sure. How can you find yourself after 10 years of self is yourself, Atma. You cannot find Atma even 10 or 100 years of sadhana. That's why it's not possible. Now and here. Why is now and here? Through clarity. Because am I missing something? That clarity has to come. That questioning is called Atma Vichara.
So, sir, when time now doesn't exist
in
space.
It doesn't exist in space or time. And time. So that's why it's nowhere. Right? But the gateway to that, now and here. Now and here means this moment is the gateway, but that now doesn't exist in space or time. Present moment is gateway to the presence. Right? That presence is I am. We'll find out that. Any questions? Shall we proceed further? Atmavichar Marga, direct path, Atmavichar Marga. I think what is that?
Now and here also is pursued by the mind only.
No, see, all teaching is for the mind only. Atma doesn't require any teaching. Right? Ultimately, for this combination, mind and Chidabhasa combination is called Jiva. For that only is the teaching. If somebody has realized the self, there's no teaching. Somebody is the mind, there's no teaching. Somebody is seeking where I am held up. For him, you have to give a pointer.
Seeker
is the self, Chidabhasa. Mind is instrument of that. The mind, I am the consciousness speaking through this body. The body is the instrument.
To understand that mind is not useful for the mind itself.
No, the mind is, that's a combination which is happening. The consciousness and the mind. Right? That's a combination. This combination is not separate. There is like a reflection of sun is there in the water. You cannot separate reflection in the water. That's one combination. So for this combination is going to suffering. The mind is no entity. So for that entity you are teaching. Finally, the Chidabhasa portion will realize that I am I.
In other words, you're saying negating the mind is also negating a part of consciousness.
Sorry?
Negating the mind is also negating a
part of consciousness. No. The mind has two aspects. A real aspect and unreal aspect. The thoughts are called unreal aspect. The present moment attention is called real aspect. You are negating the unreal aspect, which is thoughts. And attention you are taking back to self. The consciousness part is going back to self. The unreal aspect disappears, shadow disappears.
But at that moment, attention is still coming from the mind only.
The attention is the root of the mind. The attention goes back to the self. We'll do that. We'll do the exercise. Right? So any questions?
It's like, sir, if I sit in meditation, and then I'm sitting in meditation, I say, okay, I'm watching my breath. I'm paying attention to my breath. This is still a mind exercise.
No, this is the mind exercise because you are doing it in not the right way. Okay? So let's just ask for the breath meditation. Let's do a breath meditation to understand what is attention. Okay? So the question is, if I am giving attention to the breath, I am giving exercise to the mind. It's a mental exercise. The self-realization is not a mental exercise. Self-realization is self-recognizing itself, which is Chidabhasa recognizes itself as Atma. Okay, mind is the instrument. So when you give attention to the breath, it's wrongly taught that you give attention to the breath. You should give attention to who is watching, not breath. I'll guide now.
Yeah. But then who is watching, all the crowds start disappearing.
Yeah.
So eventually some dissolution is happening.
Dissolution, not dissolution.
Some part of mind is going there. Is dissolving.
Yeah, which never existed.
Yeah.
Which was actually the so-called optical illusion. So it's an illusion which dissolved. What is real remains. What is real is what you have to go back. Okay. So let us do a small breath meditation.